bought it for 10 zlotys each. 10 for this, 10 for this. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Siddhi Vlogs. I hope you are doing great and keeping yourself healthy. So in today's vlog, I am going to be sharing my personal experience of visiting a commercial Chinese market which is based out of is approximately 25 kilometers away from Warsaw. So I am going to be sharing my personal experience of going there. How did I reach there? What all I found there? And you know, what are the prices? So let's get started. So they have a, you know, center plan, and the whole commercial center is distributed in 6 trade buildings. So each building has its unique selling products. For example, trading products. For example, building 1 sells toys, garments, curtains. Building 2 sells electronics. In building 3, you'll find something else. So they have distributed all the products in these 6 trade buildings. All 6 of them are working. So which makes it even more easier and convenient for a consumer to shop. They offer you clothes, curtains, festival decorations, child items, child play items, toys, electrical appliances, utensils. I mean, you just name it and you'll find it there. So that is why I am emphasizing that you should go there. Even if you don't want to buy anything, just go there once to see the place and to find out what all you can see. Now, based on my experience, I'd like to share a few things with you all, so that if anyone of you is interested to go there, I'm sure it'll be helpful for you if you keep these tips and points in mind. The first thing is carry cash. Now, from my personal experience, I'm telling you that I had gone to all 6 trade buildings, and wherever I went, nobody was willing to accept cards or any other online mode of payment, for example Blick or any other. So make sure that you have enough cash with you, and then only you'll be able to shop smoothly. Otherwise, nobody will accept cards. Of course, you can always find ATMs around, but it's very it's not always very convenient to come out of the store of the trade building and to find an ATM around and get the cash from there. So it's better that you be prepared beforehand, and when you go there, you have enough cash with you, and you can make the payment easily. Second one is try to go in groups. Now, the reason I'm saying that you should go in groups is not because of the safety concern or safety hazard. It's absolutely safe. I had gone there and they have their safety measures. It's not unsafe at all. The reason I'm saying you to go there in groups is because the clothing section there, it's a basically wholesale market. So they don't sell 1 product or 2 product or even 6 products. So either they'll sell you the products in 12s or in 10s. That can't go well with the people who are coming there to shop. For example, I liked a single t-shirt or a single dress. I have to buy 12 pieces of it or 10 pieces, whatever the minimum requirement is. A concern, and that might piss you off while shopping. So if you have friends, females, males, who shared similar interests like you and who are also going there to shop these particular things only, then I think you can share the price and you can share the cost and you can divide the products. So in that case, I think it'll be beneficial for you and it'll be cheap. Even if you don't go there in group, even if you buy the whole of 12 packet for yourself, then also it is very cost friendly. I'll tell you how. I saw a t-shirt there. It was a collar neck, a polo t-shirt basically, and it would have costed me, I think, 135 zlotys for 12 pieces. Now, for 12 pieces, I had to pay 135 zlotys. You do the maths. One t-shirt would have costed me, I think, 10 point something zlotys, let's say 10.2 zlotys, which is not a bad deal at all. Now, in that pack of 12 also, these are not going to be identical. They were offering 4 colors, so 3 t-shirts are going to be of identical color. So 4 colors and 12 pieces. So even in this deal, you're getting 4 t-shirts that are absolutely not identical to each other. So t-shirt, which is also a good idea, not bad idea at all. So, but it'll be a very good thing if you go there in groups, if your friend can take 4, if your another neighbor can take 4, then it'll be a great deal, and nothing like that. As far as the electronical shops or the utensil shop or any other department is concerned, they are willing to sell the items in single pieces. For example, you can easily find a single piece of earphone or a single piece of mobile cover. They do sell single pieces also. Third is, go there only when you have 3 to 4 hours in hand. Otherwise, don't go, it'll be a waste of time. So you have to walk a lot, from building 1 to 2, and then building 1 has I think 2 floors and 6 buildings if you have to cover inside the area, also inside stores also, then I think you must have 3 to 5 hours in hand and be prepared to spend that much there. Then only your shopping will be fruitful. Otherwise, I think it's a waste of time there to go there and just go to trade building 1 or 2 and then come back. I think you should go to all 6 of them and find out what you want to buy from there. Fourth is, before going there, just have a look at the central plan of the of all the trade buildings, because it will give you, they have given in their website also, and it will also give you an idea of what to buy from where. They have specifically mentioned which building is offering you what products, so if you know beforehand as to what to buy from where to buy, it will save your time also and energy also. Fifth is a friendly advice, don't take it otherwise, please. Whenever you're going there, make sure you have made a budget, because it often happens that whenever you're getting things at such cheaper price and such lower price, you guys, we tend to spend more on things we don't want also. So save yourself from doing so and avoid getting things that you don't need at all, and make a budget, make a shopping list for yourself. Talking about the mode of transport, I personally went there in a cab and it costed me 40 zlotys one way, so 80 zlotys to and fro, which is not a bad deal because I had got really good items from there and at a pretty reasonable price, so that did not pinch me at all. But if you're planning to go from other public transport, they're also available. You just have to find from Google or from transportation app, and you'll be able to find out which is the best public transport to reach there. So all in all, it's a perfectly organized commercial center near Warsaw that makes it even more special. Shopping from that commercial center also saves times because they are offering you almost all the products at a very cheaper rate and under one roof. So it's not a bad deal if you're planning to go there once a month or once 2 months. Share the affordability and the price range that you might find there. I'd like to share one experience with you all, that is of this. It's a silicone cover for iPhone X, and I bought it for 10 zlotys each, 10 for this, 10 for this, and believe you me, I have paid for this I think 60 zlotys when I bought it from the nearby stores. So it's 1/6, I mean, in that commercial center you are almost paying 1/6 the price, which is not bad deal at all. So believe you me, if you go there, you'll not be disappointed or disheartened. You'll have a great time and you'll enjoy shopping. So just keep these things in mind that I had shared with you, and you can always read from their website also. I'll share the link in the description below. That's all in today's video. Yo, I hope you liked the video. If you did, make sure you give it a like right away, and also consider subscribing to my channel if you're new here. Share it with your friends, share it with people who are staying in Poland or planning to come to Poland in near future. I'm sure this will be of great help to many people who are staying in Warsaw. Until we meet again, stay home, stay safe.